In this video, I'll be building this three-legged stool on the pantorouter.
And it's really quite simple. There's three of these pieces, three of the legs, plus the top. The catch is all of these mortise and tenon joints are at an angle, and this one's even a compound miter. I'll start with the joints in here for the legs, and I've got the dimensions for those here. One of the tenons needs to be cut with the template vertical, so I figured might as well use that same template for all the joints and cut the mortises like this. Now I'm going to tilt the table by 30 degrees, and there's these little notches every 15, so two of those. I want to cut the tenon to be as far down this way on this piece of wood as possible without having a piece of the mortise exposed. And that's with the router bit just a bit above here. I have the depth stop set so it just barely doesn't hit the table. And then the tenon needs to extend to where I've got this little mark. So right about here. That's too tight. I need to adjust for a slightly smaller tenon. I still need to cut that corner off. I should have cut this mortise a little bit further in this way because I lost part of the tenon here because I didn't have enough extending here. In fact, on this one, I extended the mortise just a little bit, just to give me more room here. From here to where this ends should be about 18.4, and at 8 degrees from square, and that should actually come perpendicular to the middle here, like so. Now I added 3.5 centimeters for the length of the tenon, and I tilted the bandsaw at 13 degrees, so now I can cut that off. Now the tenon that goes on this end is the one that's at a funny compound angle, and I just realized I cut this bevel the opposite direction of what I have in the drawings. So what I'll just do is I'll make a mirror image of what I have, but that's okay. And here's the setup for that joint, with the workpiece needs to be at an 8-degree angle on the table and the table tilted 13 degrees. Now with a bigger bevel gauge, I can set this angle, and I need to make sure the follower is straight above the tenon template, and I want that bit to come to the line here and be centered in the wood. And cutting this tenon involves some side forces, so I'm adding a side stop again and clamping it firmly. Now you may have noticed this edge and this edge, you can see here, are not quite parallel, and that's actually why I cut the tenons standing up like this on the table instead of like this, because if I cut it like this, this edge would be parallel to here, but I actually need a slight bit of twist because of the way these are angled, otherwise the stool itself will have a twist to it. Because the legs that go on here actually need to converge in one point, and that point is here. If this was parallel to this, the legs would be parallel to that, and they would sort of miss each other because they'd be going along these lines, and the whole stool would have a twist. And now cutting the mortises in the legs. Thank you. Now I want to carve some round tenons on the end of these legs. And there's even some tenon templates that they sell with a pantorouter. But this one's kind of small. This one only makes a half inch tenon. I want a tenon this size. That's 1 1/8. And so for that, I need a much bigger template. So working it out, the tenon is 27.5 millimeters. I sweep around that with a half inch bit, 12.7. So I need to sweep a circle of 40.2 millimeters. The pantograph doubles that at the follower, so times 2 is 80.4, minus 22 millimeters that the follower already has. That means the template needs to be 58.4 millimeters in diameter. Put a deep countersink in here because the screw I've got is kind of short, and also the whole template is tapered, which allows me some fine adjustment. I set the distance between the depth stops here to be just a bit more than the thickness of the stool top, and that way, with the router all the way back, I can use the tip of the router as a guide to where to position the stop. And the table is tilted 13 degrees because the legs join the top at an angle. I'm routing a 1/4 inch roundover on all the exposed edges. Just checking that the legs actually form an equilateral triangle. I have to glue the last piece on separately because my jointer isn't quite wide enough. Thanks to the clamps across the edges, I managed to glue that last piece on perfectly flat. I drew a Y, three lines 120 degrees apart, and placed the legs on there, and just marking where they end up for where to drill the holes. This whole thing came about because Mac Sheldon, who is pretty much Mr. Pantorouter these days, asked me to come up with a set of plans that involve some compound miter joinery. And I drew these up, and he'll be selling them on his website. I'll also be selling them on my website. Now, I cut the mortise and tenon joints with a template here vertically, but I don't recommend that. So except for the one compound miter, I recommend you cut all the mortise and tenons with a template horizontally and just mount the workpiece at an angle. And if you built your own pantorouter and it doesn't have a tilting table, then just make yourself a wedge here so you can get this up by 13 degrees and then place it at an angle like that. And that will allow you to cut that one compound miter, and everything else with a template horizontal you can put flat on the table. Now, one thing you can't get on a homemade pantorouter is this dust shroud thingy here, and that actually works really well. So if you want to buy one of these, they are unfortunately rather expensive, up there in price with things like Sawsop and Festool. But you can get $100 off by using discount code MW3 at www.pantorouter.com. And one thing about a three-legged stool is, it will never rock, even if the floor is way uneven.